Deux fois je l'ai vu, mille fois je l'ai senti.
Saint Bertrand de Comminges is a decayed town on the spurs of the Pyrenees, not very far from Toulouse and still nearer to Bagnères de Luchon. It was the site of a bishopric until the Revolution and has a cathedral, which is visited by a certain number of tourists. In the spring of 2010, an Englishman arrived at this old world place. They can hardly dignify it with the name of city, but there are not 1,000 inhabitants. He was a Cambridge man, who had come specially from Toulouse to see Saint Bertrand's church, and had left two friends who were less keen archaeologists than himself in their hotel at Toulouse under promise to join him on the following morning. Our Englishman had come early on the day in question and proposed to himself to fill a notebook and to use several dozens of pictures in the process of describing and photographing every corner of the wonderful church that dominates the little hill of Comminges. In order to carry out this design satisfactorily, it was necessary to monopolize the verger, or the sacristan of the church, for the day.
What on earth is his problem? Is he oppressed by a guilty conscience? Or is he an unbearably henpecked husband? I think the latter, a termagant wife. But even so, something more formidable than a nagging wife must be the reason, surely. Why won't he leave me alone in here? Perhaps I'm keeping him from his déjeuner, or maybe he thinks I'll steal St. Bertrand's ivory crozier, or that dusty stuffed crocodile that I saw hanging over the font earlier.
mind you go home. I'm quite capable of doing my notes on my own. You can lock me in if you want.
Par Dieu, laissez monsieur seul dans l'église. Il n'en est pas question. Deux ou trois heures pour moi, c'est pas important. J'ai bien mangé, en plus.
Very well, my little man. You've been warned and must take the consequences.
C'est lui.
Non, personne, personne. La porte est fermée.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Non, personne. Nothing, monsieur, monsieur. The door is locked. Locked.
Sum betrandus, liberavit hominum quem diabolus, deo volibat strangulare. How St. Bertrand delivered a man whom the devil long sought to strangle. Very odd. Why on earth should a daub of this kind affect anyone so strongly? The man must be a monomaniac. What is his monomania?
Monsieur semblait intéressé au lieu libre de cœur dans la sacristie.
Funny that. I was going to ask him if there was a library in the town.
Si monsieur s'intéresse au lieu libre, j'ai quelque chose à la maison qui pourrait m'intéresser. I have something to my home for you. Your manuscript.
Ah, d'accord, oui.
Intéressé.
Oui, oui. Is it far?
No. And let me talk.
Okay, go.
You follow me?
Okay.
At last. Maybe this is what I've been looking for. Priceless medieval manuscript, hidden in a rural part of France for hundreds of years. But then on the other hand, it's probably just a stupid missal of Platin's painting, about 1580. Where is the likelihood that a place so near Toulouse would not have been ransacked long ago by collectors? Maybe it's a decoy to get my money. Sneaky old goat.
I'm expecting two friends of mine to turn up early tomorrow morning.
Oh, well, very well, monsieur. Vos amis vous accompagnent. Ils devront vous accompagner, c'est bien, c'est bien.
Sorry, speak too quickly.
They are accompanying you, always near you.
Ah, oui, oui, yes, d'accord, yes.
Yeah. Perhaps, monsieur, has not the time.
Not at all. I've got until tomorrow. Let's see what you have.
Too large for a missile, and not the shape of an antiphoner. Perhaps it may be something good after all. Existed as late as the 12th century in Nîmes. This book must return to Cambridge with me, even if I have to use up all the money in my bank account. I wonder if it's for sale.
If monsieur return home to the end.
Now that's odd. This part of the book must be contemporary with the unprincipled Canon Alberic. He would doubtless plunder the chapter library of Saint Bertrand to form this priceless scrapbook.
Interrogatum est in veniamne.
Answers of the 12th of December, 1694. It was asked, shall I find it? Answer, thou shalt. Shall I become rich? Thou wilt. Shall I live an object of envy? Thou wilt. Shall I die in my bed? Thou wilt.
Perfect specimen of the treasure hunter's record.
Oh yes, monsieur, yes.
Quite reminds one of Mr. Minor Canon Quatermain in All St. Paul's.
I will take 250 euros, no more.
It's incredible. I can't argue with that. You got yourself a deal. Merci beaucoup.
Merci. Monsieur souhaite-t-il que je raccompagne à son hôtel?
Ah, no, it's fine. The Chapeau Rouge Hotel is just down the road, it's 100 meters. I'll be fine, it's very kind.
Ah, ok. Je voudrais faire un petit cadeau à monsieur.
Oh, crucifix, no.
Si.
No need.
Ce gift pour monsieur, un cadeau. Monsieur en aura besoin.
Merci. Well, merci beaucoup, monsieur.
Au revoir, monsieur.
Thank you very much for everything, and nice to meet you. Okay.
Bon courage.
Merci. Bonsoir.
J'espère que tout ira bien ce soir pour monsieur.
Quoi qu'il en soit, Pierre et Bertrand resteront ici cette nuit.
Ah, ça me rassure.
Bless Canon Alberic. I wonder where he is now.
Phenomenon. Good lord, I wish my landlady would stop laughing like that. What a dreadful noise. Nobody would think there was somebody dead in the house. It's just...
pen wiper. No. No such thing in the house. A rat. No, no, too black. A large spider. Oh, I trust to goodness not. No. Oh, good God. A hand like the hand in that picture. The Latin text on the reverse of the small painting by Canon Alberic translates thus: Solomon against the night demon, painted by Alberic de Mauleon, according to God who lives. Saint Bertrand drives away the demon, intercepting it on my wretched behalf. First seen the night of the 12th of December, 1694. Here again soon. Act inappropriately and suffer more. Suffer.